Okay, prepare yourselves. Buckle up. This is going to be a very long Trader Joe's haul, I feel like, because I got a lot of new stuff that I never got before, because before I went to Trader Joe's today, I was like, what should I even get from Trader Joe's, because I was running out of food. But then at the same time, I was kind of getting sick of my food that I have been eating lately. At the same time, I really, really want to eliminate all sugar, all little amounts of sugar. I want to eliminate dairy completely. Cow's milk. And I want to minimize meat and salt. So basically just honing in on the things that I have already been doing, because lately it's been affecting me a lot more. And that's just a sign of I'm getting healthier, so the extra little things are just affecting me more because my machine is so finely tuned, or almost so finely tuned, that these little specks of sand are throwing me out of whack. Feel me? Also, I'm hungry. Also, I'm tired. Also, I'm stressed out because, like, my worst class that I have was today. So, and there was only 3 kids in the class today. So, what should that tell you? That class is terrible, but kids are just different, you know? Kids are just different. They have different personalities. They have different needs. So I have to adjust to the different class environments. And it just so happens that this class is very rambunctious, very talkative. That's why I have gray hairs. Anyways, cool. I could literally tell you, this hair is for Butterba and this hair is for Da-na-na. Literally. Cool. Anyways, yes, I got a whole bunch of new stuff. So, I mean, part of it is, yes, to try new food, but also part of it is to kind of motivate me to try different recipes, because I really want to cook differently. Like, the stuff I can cook is pretty good, but like I said, I was getting bored with it. So I got a whole bunch of new food, and hopefully I make the time to cook and to look up different recipes with the stuff that I bought. So, also, a friend of a friend is actually a macrobiotic cook. She, gets paid to cook, for sick people, and she might be coming back into town, and if she does, I'm gonna try to learn some things from her so I could cook for myself and for other people whenever that happens. Cool. So I got some Power to the Greens, leafy greens. I got 2 bags of this staple. Nothing new. And actually, you guys are gonna kind of freak out. These are actually good. What? Okay, in other videos I have said greens are nasty, and like for the most part, yes. But I'm not sure which leafy green in this mixture that I'm tasting the most, but it tastes really good. Especially just like when I steam it up and put it in my miso soup, that's like when I can notice the flavor the most, and it's like so good. It might be having to do with the miso, but is really good in miso soup. So, pro tip. Cool. Then I just got some green onions. That's another staple. Nothing new. This, I always see and I'm always like, that looks different. That looks cool. What would I even do with that? I don't know, but I just got them today. They're the Belgian endives. And they look like there's some kind of, it says, oh, endive. Belgian endive. Tells you how to pronounce it. I thought it was endive, but I guess it's endive. Is a member of the chicory family. It has a crisp texture and a sweet, nutty flavor with a mild bitterness. Great served raw or cooked. So it has three little endives. 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 Oh, and it has a recipe back here. Oh, cool. So that's a new vegetable I haven't tried before. And organic broccoli, like just a staple, you know, just a staple. Just in case my new vegetables didn't turn out so good, I have my staples to fall back on. You can never have too many vegetables, girl. Never too many vegetables. Anyways, then I got these organic crimini mushrooms. Cool. These are my go-to mushrooms lately. And then I just got some organic whole carrots. I got these kinds, honestly, because these were 79 cents and the multi-colored carrots were like $2 or $3. I was just in a money-saving mentality today. So, I need a carrot, so I just got the cheaper version. And then these is another new vegetable that I haven't tried that I'm like, should I get it? Nah. And then today I was like, fuck it. So, I got these fennels. Look at, they're huge. Do you see? And I know that at Lush we used fennel in a few products. It's very stimulating. But, so I don't know what I'm going to do with this. But they're very heavy. Fennel. They look like some kind of onion, so I'm guessing it's probably very similar to an onion. Cool. Then, this bag is heavy. Then I got these, which I'm pretty sure I got before. They're the organic corn chip dippers. And I looked at the ingredients because I remember I got these and I did like them. And I wanted to get some kind of chip, you know, because I'm really, although Haba chips are the bomb and they're great, I'm pretty sure they're like, because they're made from corn and soybean oil and soy sauce. And it doesn't say on there, but they're not organic and they're not, you know, non-GMO. So it's really not a good idea for me to be eating those all the time. But I still wanted to get some kind of chip. But I didn't want to get the plain unsalted tortilla chips from Trader Joe's because I just can't. Plain chips are not my thing. I eat them when I'm at my boyfriend's house because that's the kind of chips he eats. But, like, for me, I don't want to buy them for myself and then have them here. Like, thanks, girl. Anyways, but these just have organic corn, organic sunflower oil, and sea salt. So, I thought this was a better option for me. Then I got some more things that I never tried before. I got these fresh shallots, which they are like a member of the onion family, I think, or they're like garlic. Yeah, I look on here. See here, it's kind of like garlic. I mean, I'm not really sure how I'm supposed to use this, but I just got it. Who knows, right? Variety, okay? You need variety in your eating, what you eat, and your cooking styles. You know, because it's not good to just keep on eating the same thing over and over again. No matter how healthy what you're eating is, it's not good. You need variety so you won't get bored and also to get different nutrients. Cool, I said it like a million times. Cool. Then I got this giant bag. 3 pounds of brown jasmine rice. Yeah, Trader Joe's doesn't sell short grain rice, and They just sell like medium grain or long grain, and they do that year round. So, medium grain is best for like moderate temperatures of climate, and short grain is for colder weather. Long grain is for warmer weather. Yang and yin. And this is in between, so I thought it was fine. But yeah, I just need some brown rice. And I didn't want to go to Sprouts because that's usually where I get my short grain brown rice. But I didn't want to go to Sprouts because they have way too many extra goodies there that I'll be tempted to buy. And I was like, girl, you can't. So I just went to Trader Joe's. Also, Trader Joe's, I end up buying more but paying less. I think because, exactly because Sprouts does have extra little goodies and then they price them more expensive than, like, you know. Excuse me. Anyways, then I got this unsweetened vanilla rice drink for my cereal and whatnot. And then I got these green lentils. Because I really want to make myself start cooking my beans, like my protein. What would you consider lentils a bean? I'm not really sure. But they had red ones too, and I wanted to buy the green and the red, but I was like, girl, you're not a Rockefeller. Cool. So yeah. So I just got those for protein, and then you guys, I really went crazy at Trader Joe's today. I bought so many new things. Okay, then I got this mixed nut butter. It has dry roasted and salted almonds, cashews, walnuts, Brazil nuts, hazelnuts, and pecans. So I'm excited to try this because I didn't want to buy peanut butter because I was getting sick of my peanut butter, my go-to peanut butter. So I was like, but I want to get something kind of like. So I saw this, and it has a little bit of sea salt in it. So I thought it would be okay. Cool girl. Then I got this ginger root, fresh ginger root. Ginger is like another superfood that is not always talked about. I feel like it is talked about a lot, but I don't know. But anyways, I just got some fresh ginger. I can't remember all the benefits off the top of my head, but I know there's like a million because in the macrobiotic books I read, it talks about ginger a lot, has recipes with ginger. And recently, I think I saw a video just like on Facebook, just like listing all these benefits of ginger. So I was like, cool, let me get it. What can it hurt? It can't. Oh, and then I just got some baking powder. Baking powder, it says aluminum free and double acting, and baking soda. Just because I've been experimenting lately with baking, you know, healthier baked goods, and I wanted to get some non-GMO baking soda and baking powder. Because everything at Trader Joe's is non-GMO. That's Trader Joe's brand, and this is Trader Joe's brand. And then I got this other seasoning. I saw this. I follow this Instagram account. Excuse me. I think I'm not sure which one it was, because I follow a Trader Joe's shopper. I don't know what it's called. But I know I follow one that's like a girl or someone, I don't know, that always shops at Trader Joe's. And then I follow one that's like a vegan Trader Joe's shopper. So on one of those accounts, I saw them, they posted this. And it's called Everything But the Bagel Sesame Seasoning Blend with sea salt, garlic, and onion. So it's basically supposed to be everything you would put on an everything bagel, but like in a seasoning. Isn't that so freaking cool? So it has sesame seeds, sea salt flakes, dried minced garlic, dried minced onion, black sesame seeds, poppy seeds. I was like, how cool. Isn't that so freaking cool? Oh my God. If I make my own bagels or bagel chips. Cool. Then I got this bag of Mandarin. Trader Joe's does not sell cuties anymore. I have not seen cuties at Trader Joe's for a very long time. Did they have a fight? Did they have a falling out? Did they have a Twitter feud? What's wrong with my face today, honestly? I put on a little bit of makeup. I don't know what's wrong with my face today. I think it's because I ate In-N-Out last night. That's another reason why I think I went ham at Trader Joe's today, because I was like, felt so bad about eating that burger yesterday. It's not, I mentally felt bad, but also physically felt bad. So probably showing in my face today. That's great. Cool. Then I got this. Okay, they had a few little Middle Eastern little pre-made things. And I was caught between, I wanted to get them all, but I was like, just buy one, Michelle, and then next time buy the other ones. So this is tabbouleh, right? I don't know. I'm sorry if I didn't say it right. Traditional Middle Eastern salad, and it's vegan. It has tomatoes, parsley, bulgur wheat, onions, canola oil, water, extra virgin olive oil, mint leaves, sea salt, citric acid, black pepper. So I thought this was cool. It's like a mixed grain little salad. Not mixed grain, it just has one grain. But I thought it was cool and interesting, so I was like, let me get it. Whole grain plus other healthy stuff, it looked cool. So I was like, yay. Oh, and the last thing I got in this bag is a white bean and basil hummus. So it comes in this big old thing. It says 1 pound. 1 pound of hummus. I wanted to try a new hummus, so I got this one. So we'll see if it's good. Cool. Then I got another thing of dried beans, organic black beans, so I can, you know, get in the habit of cooking, you know, my food instead of buying it in cans, because canned food doesn't give you as much energy as fresh food could give you, so. And you want the best quality food, the kind that's going to give you the most energy, so that you can be the healthiest and the happiest, and everything can work to the best. Everything can work to its best potential. Cool. And then I got these. I don't know how you even say them. Saka Inchi beans. Seeds. Okay, let me read you what it says. Toasted Saka Inchi seeds, sea salt. Enjoy Saka Inchi seeds in trail mix on soups and salads or straight out of the bag. I don't know where this is from. Because that's not an American name. So I don't know where the seed is from. It sounds like it's like an Asian thing. This is what it looks like. I like that. It tastes like a nut, but it tastes kind of like vegetable-y. I like those. Cool. Then I got this almond, unsweetened vanilla milk for cereal and whatever you want to use milk for. And then I got this apple juice. Organic, unfiltered apple juice from fresh, ripe apples. I got this instead of the cold-pressed one that I usually get. Because I told you, I was just sick of all my food. So I just wanted to get all new stuff. So I got this. And this is what my boyfriend does. He does apple juice with a little bit of the sparkling mineral water. So then it's like a little apple soda. Yep, and it tastes so good. Last bag. Oh my god, I guess this video won't be that long. Cool, you guys. So, I got this goat cheese and sun-dried tomato ravioli. Honestly, because I was very hungry and I was just walking all through Trader Joe's and I was like, what looks good and is healthy? So I got this. Yes, I said I didn't want to be eating any more dairy, but goat cheese is actually more acceptable because goats are smaller animals than humans are. So, I mean, according to macrobiotic principles, it's more acceptable, you feel me? So, that's fine, that's cool. Anyways, then I got this organic chopped spinach to put in my fruit smoothies to get extra greens in wherever I can because I'm not always on top of my green intake. For the most part, I am. But sometimes I'm not, so it's just better just to eat more. Who's gonna get mad at you? How's that a problem? Eat more greens. What's the problem? There's no problem. I don't get it. But anyways, then I got this shredded bite-sized wheat. Wheat. It just has whole wheat. And vitamin E to preserve freshness. Yeah, I put this with fresh blueberries, with almond milk or soy milk or oat milk. Tastes so good. You could put other stuff in it too, but that's just the way I've been eating it lately. And it tastes so good. And it's all nutritious and delicious and no sugar. And so whole. It's like so cool. Then this, okay, it looks kind of weird, right? It says vegetable bird's nests. What? They look like little vegetable bird's nests. So weird, right? Okay, so I read what's in it. Onion, carrot, kale, tempura batter, soybean oil, salt, glucose. What is even glucose? I'm not even sure. Isn't that sugar? Or some kind of thing relating to sugar? I think so. Or is that gluten? Something like that. And beta carotene. That says color. I guess it's just color. But anyways, I thought it was fine because it was a vegetable. It's basically like a tempura kind of thing. And I freaking love tempura. Okay. Ugh. So I think this will be fine. And it says to eat. Oh, and it comes with soy sauce too. But I'm just going to use my soy sauce that I have. Because I think this one, the one that comes in here, has sugar in it. And if you just buy the low reduced sodium soy sauce from Trader Joe's, it's a better option. It's like $1.99 probably. But yeah, it's just, so just got these for a fun little extra thing, you know, a little fun little thing, little healthy extra thing, not too off balance. And then I got this roasted vegetable pizza. I freaking love this pizza. It's so freaking good. Okay, it has, let me read you what it has on here. Hand stretched crust made with wheat flour and extra virgin olive oil, which is topped with sweet caramelized onions, shiitake mushrooms, red peppers, and artichoke hearts. Dairy free. There's no cheese in it. But it's very, very delicious. And I'm not gonna lie to you. When I make this at home, I end up eating the whole thing in one sitting. Don't get mad at me, okay? Like, eating a lot of healthy things is better than eating even just a little bit of unhealthy things, you feel me? Oh, anyways. Woo! Then I got this organic edamame, fully cooked soybeans in pod. So you can serve them hot or cold, good source of protein and fiber. USDA organic. Look, they made it look legit with the little characters. But yeah, edamame is great. It's like it said, extra source of protein and fiber. Last thing I got, are these organic blueberries to put in my cereal. They're so delicious. But that's everything. Everything I got from Trader Joe's. Comment down below if you have tried any of these things and if you like them or what looks interesting to you or just anything you want except for hate comments. But then again, if you want to leave a comment, hateful or not, it's just extra percentages of pennies for me, so it's up to you, girl. Anyways, thanks for watching this video. See you guys in the next one. Later, haters.